This is great.
This is awesome.
Is the hazard of wearing really ripped up jeans. What happened to you? Did Wolverine attack you?
Yes, and I said yes afterwards.
Howdy, y'all. It's Becca Frucht, and welcome to Top That, your weekly pop culture cheat sheet to what everyone is and will be talking about on the web. Each week, we count down our top five of what's hot on the web, everything you need to know, and I am joined by amazing, perfect, flawless, special guest, Shauna Malcolm! Was that dramatic enough?
I was thinking that you were gonna let me down, but you didn't.
I was searching. But you found it.
You found it. That was beautiful.
I got there.
Both our hands are up.
It's like that this? Kind of a it moment. It was like I had a transcendent moment.
And I felt it. I felt it. Oh my God, I experienced it here.
Like right in here. My number five, PewDiePie on South Park. This was one of those crossover moments. Now, let's be real here, though. PewDiePie is huge. He has, like, over 32 million subscribers.
He's the biggest channel.
He is a gamer YouTuber. Are you a bit of a gamer?
Ghetto Gaming every Monday. Hey, yo, Shauna.
See how I set you up? How I just, like...
You did, and I knocked it down. I knocked it down.
Jesus Christ! Is he near me?
So, he made a little cameo on, actually, two episodes of South Park. Let's, like, watch a little snippet. Let's relive it.
But what are you watching?
How's it going, Rose? My name is
PewDiePie.
I wonder how he came up with that.
I feel like there's a backstory filled with lots of pain.
We're playing Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. Here we go. Oh, people are shooting at me, Rose.
When South Park makes fun of you, you have arrived.
You've made it.
All my little brother wants to do is sit on YouTube watching this PewDiePie play video games.
It's a whole thing. It's the culture of gaming on YouTube. You watch other people play the game instead of playing it yourself.
Hey, bros, what's going on? This is Cardmada. Be sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, because subscribing makes you feel good! So today I'm going to comment on Call of Duty. More specifically, I'm going to comment on my friends commenting on Call of Duty, so let's start!
He starts commentating on the episode of South Park.
All I wanted was to play one level of Call of Duty.
Talking about Call of Duty to Stan.
He said the living room is for old people.
I don't get it. Stan's such a douchebag. He just agrees with Cal no matter what.
Look at Stan here.
God, these guys are so annoying, aren't they?
That's actually a pretty good Cartman. I'm not even gonna lie. That was a pretty good Cartman. Because you had the shoulders up with the voice. My number five. All them crazy YouTubers doing the ice bucket challenge.
Oh my gosh. Literally captivated the world.
The world.
Everybody and their brother was doing this. Here's Lil Zoella in her Harry Styles t-shirt, Miranda Sings.
Miranda Sings getting...
We're seeing a lot of shower action here. Oh, Seth is shirtless.
I mean,
look at his tan. Look at his little...
I'm looking at a nipple. Sorry. It's hard to focus.
Hysterical. Strawberry.
Strawberry seven. I say scraw.
Strawberry.
I say scrawberry. Ricky getting all shirtless. He cut down here, y'all. Yeah, like you see him in them shirts, you don't realize he real cut. Praise the Lord for the ice bucket challenge. That's what I got to say.
And it did a lot of good.
I mean, that too.
For a worthy cause.
For a really worthy cause. Yeah. Lou Gehrig's disease. I get all that.
Yes.
But the shirtless men's. Shauna says thanks. Just saying.
My number four. We're getting literary. YouTubers blowing it up with books in 2014.
Up. Blowing it up.
Look, like the pages were flying off the shelf.
Like that.
I'm giving you a book. This is huge. Hey, let me just say, off the top of my head, Hannah Hart's book, right? My Drunk Kitchen.
Shows did.
Which I believe ended up on the New York Times bestseller. As did Grace's book, Grace's Guide.
Which only just came out.
Yeah.
I'm like,
boom. Literally, they are pooping these books out right onto bestseller lists. Zoella, of course, that's
yes, there's
thing.
A whole other controversy, that's but a, still.
Listen, girlfriend with this book, Girl Online, broke J.K. Rowling and I think E.L. James that wrote Fifty Shades of Grey. Yeah.
Okay.
Broke their first week sales.
You know, I'm sure they're at home slapping the shit out of themselves.
Her man Alfie also wrote a book, The Pointless Book.
Because he's a pointless blog.
Yeah, there you go.
I think a lot of times people think YouTubers are just young and idiots and we just make videos and it's super easy to just vlog or whatever it is. But showing them that we're able to do things and it be successful in traditional forms of media gives us a whole new level of respect. So my number four is Tyler Oakley and Bethany Mota. Kicking ass at the Teen Choice Awards. Just saying.
You want to talk about going to like just a traditional form of media? That's like boom up in TV's gut.
Bethany Mota!
court.
I know, right? And she there in her cute dress. Them heels was killer. I'd be scared for her. I was like, girl, can you walk?
And then, I mean, Tyler basically is having like got a little bit of like Taylor Swift face. Look at it. Oh my god, and his hair is just like confection.
It was fire.
Hi y'all. Thank you to Team Internet. This is like the biggest win for the internet.
His whole thing is like, we're all a team.
But it's true. You know, when you have a successful video, it feeds interest in other people's channels and things that are related. It's amazing. But
it's a karmic loop.
But having success in traditional media, as we're doing with the books, as you mentioned, and then now with things like recognition on a level of Teen Choice.
I mean, is there anything more illustrious? I think not.
Maybe
a Nobel Peace Prize.
Maybe.
My number three, Miss Glamorazzi on Project Runway.
Woo!
Now, this was a match made in heaven. I mean, it makes sense to have Ingrid come on Project Runway.
Oh my gosh, we were so in love with Bradford's red carpet look and then the street style look. Oh my gosh.
So she was one of the Threads judges and got to like throw out her opinion. Give her sartorial advice.
I love how he personalized it by drawing the lips. Definitely a piece that I could see like a downtown chick wearing.
She's been on Pop Sugar Girls Guide. She had her own.
I know.
Her own series that was precious.
And when we were hanging out on that panel, she said she wanted to collab, but my phone didn't ring. She didn't text.
What I personally look for in a red carpet dress is something that stands out, whether it's because it has a ton of opulence or drama, or because it's simplistic and modern.
Absolute congrats to her because she's built a brand, she's built a business, and it's always amazing to me and very empowering to me as a woman when I see young women building their own careers and creating their own opportunities. And then when traditional media is like recognizing them, I'm like, listen, they've been fabulous for a while now, but I'm glad. Okay, that's a perfect tie-in. That's a perfect
preach.
Pun.
Preach.
Done.
Preach.
Done. My number three is Bethany Mota on Dancing with the Stars. I about damn lost my mind. And she was with Derek Hough, who the cutest of them all. I'm just saying.
Look how freaking cute she was in this piece. Look at her little 50s.
My only like pretty was her flicks and kicks, because her legs kind of long.
You really do watch
Listen, don't get down if you ain't ready for Dancing with the Stars.
She's clearly like, knows the moves, but it's like, got enough time to make adorable facial expressions and get down.
Do it, girl. You was pumping your long legs. They too long. They just real long for that dance.
So
but you did good.
All right, so probably the biggest release of 2014 was Troye Sivan's TRXYE.
You mean Trixie?
Hello everyone, my name is Troye Sivan and I feel like I have some explaining to do.
This hashtag blew up. It was everywhere. And then Happy Little Pill, that music video dropped. In the crowd alone. It's like super moody and cool and like was funky. I really liked it.
I felt like it upped my cool points, which is hard to do because I'm already so amazingly cool here.
Look at his hair with that little bloop. He's adorable. Anyways, stinking cute. It's ridiculous. Another group that...
Wait, no. Hold up, girl. Hold up. Don't tell me you're going to talk about my booze. Don't tell me you're going to talk about my booze. Say who you gonna say. Don't play with my emotions.
Can you pay my bills? Can you pay my telephone bills? Can you pay my automobiles? If you did, maybe we could chill.
I love their covers. They're unbelievable. They're
incredibly
talented.
It's painful.
Baby boy, stay on my mind. Fulfill my fantasy.
Girl, tell me how you feel.
I think about you all the time. Rhythm's got me feeling crazy.
And of course, the music industry. The world is taking note. I mean, they're going to be in Pitch Perfect 2.
Two, yeah.
Which is super badass.
They did something with Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Yeah. People are like, can we work with you? Because the stuff you're doing is dope.
Is amazeballs.
Is ridiculous.
How about the motion picture world?
Let's do that.
Let's talk about that.
I love a good motion picture.
Yeah. Two amazing movies by two sets of YouTubers.
Yes.
How about that?
Because, there were so many YouTubers involved in both.
And then, Chester C is shirtless. And thank you. Thank you so much.
am grossed out and sad about this.
But this is so cool that they pulled this like together.
Amazingly cool.
And that these three ladies did it together. I love the Holy Trinity.
Absolutely.
Truly.
So that was one level of impressive. And then Shane Dawson partnered with The Chair, which is a Starz television show.
It was a docuseries for Starz where they take one script and have two different directors make the same script.
And he crushed that, and he ended up winning the competition because his movie was voted to be the best of the two.
I'm not trying to make a artsy movie. I definitely wanted to go broad teen comedy.
Bye, gross, stupid fucking bitch! Kidding, not really.
My number Top one, it. I'm going icons. I'm going legends. Mm-hmm. We have YouTubers rubbing shoulders, making content with like some of the biggest names in the industry, okay?
Hi, I'm Jerry Seinfeld, and this is Comedians in Cars Getting Coffee.
All of these guys prior to this had been like in traditional
and more
comedy.
Established. Yeah,
yeah, exactly. Yeah. And then he invites Miranda Sings on.
My very special guest this week, Miranda, from the hugely popular Miranda Sings YouTube channel, show, whatever the hell it is.
It went so well that he was like, I'm gonna call up my girl Colleen, because I just roll with her like that. Like, hey girl, you wanna go on the Tonight Show with me? She's like, yeah, I guess I'm fine.
Please welcome Miranda Sings and Jerry Seinfeld. Hey.
And like, I just love her commitment. I mean, Miranda Sings' commitment to what she does.
Absolutely.
She does this whole episode, it's just, you're like, this is so ridiculous. And she's just like hating on everything.
That
stank face, the best of all stank faces.
And I love that on The Tonight Show, her drawings were the size of, like, they were minuscule. Like, really? You're supposed to guess based on that?
She just does not give him an inch.
Why didn't you draw something?
How did you not get that?
So for my number one, we're going to talk about Joan Rivers, may she rest in peace, and her show, In Bed with Joan.
The show is called In Bed with Joan. I'm Joan Rivers, and let's see who's coming out of my closet today.
Where she invited not one, not two, not three, but a handful of crazy, fun, super talented YouTubers to come play with her.
This is what I'm talking about. This woman she was 81, and she got it. She knew, like, the future of entertainment, what is going down, is on YouTube, and I want to work with these people.
I am just about to get in bed with Joan, and I am a little bit nervous.
And then we had Mamrie Hart was on.
Yep.
Grace. Jenna Marbles. Joan Rivers, it was such a loss, but watching these videos and seeing her interact with, like, literally the next generation, the people that are gonna, like, carry this mantle of what's, like, new and hip and edgy and different and comedy and entertainment, that was, like, a gift that she left us.
You just don't know what you're gonna get.
All right, that was the journey. That was the countdown of, like, the big YouTuber moments of 2014.
Abso-friggin-lutely.
So I wanna know what moments we may have missed, if there are any. Feel free to just blast it in the comments and make sure and like and subscribe if you too are an insane fan of this YouTuber countdown.
Absolutely.
It was just so much. Where can they find you?
You can find me on youtube.com/heyyoshana. And actually, I'm in the middle of a holiday giveaway. I'm giving away a bunch of free stuff all the way from now until Christmas. So, yeah.
Thank you so much for joining this whole year of Top That, too. Like, literally, you guys.
These are good people.
Have sustained something that means the world to me, and I love it so, so, so much. Yeah. Anyways, guys, go snuggle with whoever's, you know,
nearby.
If you're on the subway watching this, please snuggle with a weirdo.
Yeah. Bring a little love for the holidays.
Happy holidays.
Bye. Happy holidays.
Let it go.